Cheap and Cheerful. So I recently bought this power strip, power board, extension socket, whatever you call it. Thousands of these things have been sold from sites like Temu, Amazon, AliExpress, both this model and others like it. Now, I didn't buy this because I wanted to use it, of course. I bought it because it looked terrible, and I love buying terrible, cheap crap at sometimes finding a diamond in the rough, but spoiler alert, there are no diamonds today, boys and girls. It's horseshit all the way down, so grab your shovel, peg your nose, and let's get digging. So I got this one with my own money from my favourite store, AliExpress. My employer may as well just pay my salary directly into Ali at this point, but yeah, I paid $7.50 Australian. The price will be different unless you live in Australia and bought it at the exact same time I did. This is why I post a screenshot of what I paid. Not that I'm telling you to buy this. Do not buy this. It's awful, but I often get people, usually my Ameri friends, complaining the price is higher than what I said. Well, Australia has a free trade agreement with China, which means they can dump all of Chairman Xi's most glorious, super happy golden landfill tech directly into our gullets with no taxes paid. Beautiful.
It's beautiful, 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 beautiful.
Short answer, be Australian.
Sweet, mate.
The reason I got this was because one of my favourite YouTubers, Big Clive, he did a video on a similar board, which was hilariously bad. Among other things, the earth wire was fake. Like, literally, there was the plastic wire coating the sheath, no metal inside, all kinds of other bad stuff. So I wanted to see how this Australian-specific model, which has 3,000 units sold, putting my countrymen in danger. Something very Australian about that word. Surely not all of those 3,000 people bought it to take it apart and laugh at how bad it was like me. Nope, they've set it up in their homes, in their kitchens and bedrooms and lounge rooms. And don't worry, your merry friends, there's a terrible US version too, and a terrible European version. We can all have dangerous self-igniting power boards to warm our lounge rooms and our very hearts. Now, if you've ever tried to add a power board to your kitchen wall, outlet, or anywhere really, you end up with this big ass thing dumped there with a meter of cable just going nowhere, and it's a real mess. But this is the ultimate solution. No stupid long cable, it doesn't take any bench space, it just kind of hangs on the wall. It's even got a special surprise shock 240 volt USB ports. The buttons are deceptively good feeling, not flimsy or anything. And I kind of suspect, not that anyone would ever do such a thing, I kind of suspect maybe it might be heavily influenced by another product. Maybe an original design is out there somewhere made to actual electrical safety standards. Probably costs $100 or something stupid. If you know of a product branded like this, tell me because I want to buy it. Anyway, let's get into it. It comes in this supremely tacky 80s style plastic bag case thing with the little clip. Yeah, with those little clips and the cardboard inserts. It's a whole nostalgic trip here. Pretty good for $7.50. The board itself feels surprisingly sturdy and solid. The plug looks good to the layman with no electrical qualifications. So let's get stuck into it with the Creative Space. Don't do this. So you've probably already spotted the first problem. Regular screws, just Phillips heads, not using security screws, meaning uneducated bogans like myself can get in. We don't even need to order a Torx driver off Temu to go along with it. That's surely against some kind of standard. Yeah, definitely no Australian, British or American standards. So pulling the back off, at first I was thinking, hey, that's actually not as bad as I was expecting. It's got a brass bus bar. Kind of disappointing. I wanted to see Disaster Zone and have a laugh, but don't you worry, she's still got some surprises shoved down her blouse. There are plenty of problems here that are potentially deadly or at least very good at starting fires. Let's start with the low-hanging fruit. So yeah, this USB power supply is terribly unsafe. It's a combo fail in terms of electrical standards. Exactly what you'd normally find inside those super cheap USB chargers on Temu. There's just no safety built in. Almost everything is wrong with it. Starting off, there's no physical separation between the high voltage side and the USB side. There's got to be a physical gap there cut into the board to prevent the 240 volts from arcing over to the bit that the human touches, the USB side. And these dodgy little transformers are shocking, quite literally. I'm not being picky here. People have died while charging their phone or their tablet because it was plugged into something like this, some crappy USB charger. It's arced over or this has failed, and there's no safety built in, so they get electrocuted. I think something really needs to be done about this kind of shit coming into the country or exiting a factory in China. In the US, any country, any factory making shit like this, which can kill people who are just chilling out in their home, it should be punishable. So yeah, that's a widowmaker, that one. I've got a video with terrible production values I made a few years ago that dives a bit deeper into it. I'll link it down somewhere. What worries me most about this board, if you look close here where you have the red wire coming in and the blue wires and neutral wires, they're actually touching. There's the wire comes out to this sharp pointy end here, both there and also here. It's literally just stabbing this blue wire in. The wire gauge is just woefully, woefully undersized. It's going to heat up, the insulation would soften, and eventually you're going to get a short here on one or both of these parts, particularly with movement and, you know, years passing. I reckon that'd be enough to start a fire, especially in an older home or a home whose RCA safety switches aren't working properly, if you don't have them, in a country that doesn't have them especially. And it's not doing the curly kind of deal that we saw in Clive's video. Does that mean it's steel? Comment below what that means. I'd like to hear what your opinion is, particularly somebody who's actually qualified in this area. Now, I'm not qualified to be making any kind of legal assessment, safety assessment on this. It's just my opinion based on the basics that I know. But I think anyone who owns one of these should throw it out now. Actually, don't just throw it out. Someone else is going to use it. Cut the cable and then throw it out, because these are a damn safety hazard. All right, that's all for now. Just a quickie today. Take care out there, dudes. Be kind, be cool, and I'll see you next time.